Hello, today's video will demonstrate an uncomplicated method for summarizing a text document of any size. The idea is to leverage a Python and LangChain-based mechanism for recursively processing specific sections of a text, which are within input token limits and therefore properly sized for LLM compatibility. Imagine a document that needs to be split into four sections for AI processing. Following the summarization of these parts and the aggregation of these segment summarizations, it's possible we may only need to divide the new summarized text into two chunks for it to run smoothly through our AI system and token limits. We continue this process until we're left with a single summarization output. If I had fully solved the AI context window scaling problem, I'd be a millionaire and making videos about life on my private island. Unfortunately, this approach is not solving the context window problem at all, only working around it, and has some major drawbacks. Chiefly, we could be multiplying hallucinations or accuracy errors across numerous stages of summarization. Meaning, by using the AI to paraphrase text multiple times, the issues in each summarization round can compound. Furthermore, if we split the text between a crucial and complicated idea, the separate processing of segments can result in an unclear expression of the idea in the summarization. We'll use some tricks to mitigate these downsides, but can't completely eliminate them. Theoretically, there's no limitation on the document length for this process. However, we need to carefully watch costs, as the summarization costs scale non-linearly with text length. On the positive side, the LangChain protocol offers portability across flagship AI models, and the approach is very customizable. Let's now jump in hands-on. Before diving into the code, make sure that your model of choice, in our case Vertex AI's Palm, is activated in your project. Once the API is enabled, our next hop will be to the IDE for setting up and running our code. We will share all the code in a Git repository, the link for which will be shared in the video description. Also, you'll find this diagram file for easy reference, remix, or reuse. Let's acquire the packages essential to run our code. The specific AI model that you use will dictate this. For Vertex, we'll need the Google Cloud AI Platform package. LangChain and a tick token tokenizer will also be employed. Next, we'll bring in some text for summarization. We have a simple tail here, which is way too lengthy for a single chat input or a text prompt using models like GPT-4 or Palm-2. We'll need our recursive approach for summarization. Now let's turn to the best part, the code. The first step is to divide our text into chunks that align with the AI models. We'll use a ceiling of roughly 4,000 tokens per chunk. Although GPT-4 and Palm-2 have a token limit around 8,000, we're opting for a smaller limit so that the context from the text segment summarization can spill over a bit and inform the next summarization. To check token limits and learn more about these models, I recommend you check out their associated technical papers. In any case, moving along, once we have those text chunks, we're going to be using the conversion chain from LangChain to summarize those segments sequentially. For each text segment, we'll be asking the model to write a summary of the text, and then we'll append that to our summarized text variable, which is just a string. We'll be asking the model to summarize the first text segment, and then, in the same chat session, we'll be asking it to sequentially summarize the text after that. This allows the model to pick up on a little bit more context from the previous summarization. We wouldn't want to submit these in separate chat sessions or AI model predictions, because then we wouldn't have the context carry over as we work down the text. Then, we'll get a block of summarized text, which we'll then use potentially recursively for more split and summarize operations. If the latest layer of recursion can process everything in a single call to our large language model, then we'll return that summarization. Otherwise, we'll do one more level of recursion and summarization. The idea behind ending with a single summary is that oftentimes the boundaries of separate text segment summarizations will be a bit disconnected. Therefore, ensuring that we have a single summarization action to create our final summary will be helpful and improve the quality a bit. That's it, about 30 lines of code. As long as we're using the Cloud Shell IDE, or we have otherwise used a command like gcloud init to initialize our connection to Google Cloud, we can go ahead and run this. Since we're getting a typing issue, we'll add that package to our requirements. So, at the first level of summarization, we're sequentially summarizing our text blocks. We need to split the initial story into two text segments. After doing a final level of summarization on the aggregated segment summaries, we get a pretty succinct final result, which nicely captures the essence of our otherwise lengthy text file. We hope this video was helpful, and we'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Thank you, and please enjoy responsibly.